Bhaskar from Bengaluru. Good morning and welcome to One and All to St. Jude's Shrine, Jhansi. Today we begin the first day of the novena, flag hoisting by Right Reverend Peter Parapolil, Bishop of Jhansi. Once again, welcome to this pilgrim center and have the blessings of St. Jude.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May God, who is the fountain of all goodness, be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us pray. All that God has created and sustains, all events He guides, and all human works that are good and have a good purpose, prompt those who believe to praise and bless the Lord with hearts and voices. He is the source and origin of every blessing. By this hoisting of the flag, we proclaim our belief that all good works together for the good of those who fear and love God. Bless this flag, which denotes the beginning of the novena days and the feast of St. Jude. Bless all the pilgrims and those who are coming here to pray. We are sure that all things we must seek the help of God, so that in complete reliance on His will, we may in Christ do everything for His glory. Amen.
Thank you. Lordship, my dear fathers and my dear brothers and sisters, you have seen the new sanctuary prepared right in front of you. It is sponsored by Mr. Melvin Rodriguez. We thank him for this generous contribution to beautify the sanctuary area of St. Jude Shrine. Now, may I request His Lordship to bless the sanctuary before we begin the Mass.
My dear fathers, my dear pilgrims, people of God, on 17th, last Sunday, in Vatican, His Holiness Pope Francis inaugurated Synod. Asked all the dioceses to start the synodal way so that we may pray for the synod and success of the synod. The Spirit of God is given to all the faithful, though we are sinners. Holy Spirit is given to all of us. We participate in the decisions of the church by participating and our communion and our living in the synodal way. This is an opening in the church to participate all the members in decision making. We here inaugurate this a synod that is happening in Rome by saying this prayer and opening the synodal way.
Please be seated. My dear brothers and sisters, the 2021-2023 Synod in the Church in our diocese just now we have inaugurated in this Holy Church on this day, 19th October 2021, the first Novena day to St. Jude Thaddeus. This Mass will be also an inaugural Mass for opening the process of this synod. This synod is described well by the theologians as the Synod on Synodality. Great theologians of the Church already foresee this Synod 2021-23, the Synod on Synodality, as a turning point in the life of the Church today. The synodal process was officially launched by Pope Francis on the 10th October 2021, and he offered the Holy Mass on Sunday, 17th October 2021. This synod is going to be the most important event in the Church after Second Vatican Council. The core idea of this synod will be the centrality of the ecclesiology of the people of God. People of God is a beautiful theme, has been already introduced by Vatican II Council. Now, during this synod, a very specific emphasis will be given on the people of God. The synodality of the synod is to walk together as one body of Christ. The bishops, the priests, and the laity will walk together. They will share their views, and they will have a common spirit of communion in the Holy Spirit with the Holy Catholic Church. And we all will take an active participation together with the bishop, the priests, and the whole Church, and we will contribute to the growth of the mission of the Church. This is the essence of this synod. This synod has three aspects: communion, participation, and mission. And this synod will be having its process on three levels: one, at the diocesan level; second, at the Church in the continent level; and third, at the level of the universal Church. Meaning to say that this synod will not confine its vicinity only to the city of Vatican, but it will be done from the grassroots level of the diocese in the local areas. Now, let us all stand and pray to the Holy Spirit that for the success of this synod, which will be uniting all of us in the power of the Spirit of the living God.
Sensibus in fulgere,
let us together say this prayer. Every day we need to pray these days this prayer. Prayer for the Synod 2021-23. We stand before you, Holy Spirit, as we gather together in your name, with you alone to guide us. Make yourself at home in our hearts. Teach us the way we must go and how we must pursue it. We are weak and sinful. Do not let us promote disorder. Do not let ignorance lead us down the wrong path, nor partially influence our actions. Let us find in you and unity, so that we may journey together to eternal life and not stray from the true path. Bless this Synod 2021-2023 and make us understand the importance of it. May we grow in spirit of communion with the Church. By our active participation, we may contribute in the growth of the mission of the Church. All this we ask you, and time, in communion of the Father and the Son, forever and ever. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. As pilgrims, we have come to this shrine to pray. Everybody tells, I am going to pray in the shrine of St. Jude. Prayer is a total submission to God. And let us surrender ourselves today in front of God and lift up our hearts to God and ask the Lord, Lord, teach us to pray. We want to pray. We want to put our petitions. We want to thank God for the graces that we have received. We want to glorify God. And today, we begin the novena of St. Jude, asking God to bless all of us gathered over here. And we will be blessed because we will be like the watchman, always ready to attend the Master whenever he comes. God is coming into our hearts, touching our hearts, touching our lives, and we surrender ourselves and lift up our hearts and pray to God, Lord, look at us in this world. In this pandemic times, we are grieved, we are miserable, we are forlorn, we are desperate. And God looks into us and blesses us so that we may be healthy once again to praise God, to thank God, to pray to God, and to be in union with God. Let us, with this intention, start this novena prayers and grow in the prayer life, in our personal life. Let's ask pardon to the Lord for all our shortcomings and failures. Repent for our sins to take part in this Eucharistic celebration. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters,
have sinned. My thoughts and my words, what I have done, what I have failed to do, my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, a Virgin, all angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Leave. Let us pray. Father, you revealed yourself to us through the preaching of our apostle Saint Jude Thaddeus. By his prayers, give your church continued growth and increase the number of those who believe in you. Grant this to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and
ever. First reading, a reading from the prophet Isaiah. If because of one man's trespass, death reigned, much more will those who receive grace reign in life. A letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brethren, just as sin came into the world through one man, and death through sin, and so death spread to all men because all sinned. If many died through one man's trespass, much more have the grace of God and the free gift by the grace of that one man, Jesus Christ, abounded for many. For if because of one man's trespass, death reigned through that one man, much more will those who receive the abundance of grace and the free gift of righteousness reign in life through the one man, Jesus Christ. Therefore, as one trespass led to condemnation for all men, so one act of righteousness leads to justification and life for all men. For as by the one man's disobedience the many were made sinners, so by the one man's obedience, the many will be made righteous. Where sin increased, grace abounded all the more, so that as sin reigned in death, grace also might reign through righteousness, leading to eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke. At that time, Jesus said to his disciples, "Stay dressed for action, and keep your lamps burning, and be like men who are waiting for their master to come home from the wedding feast, so that they may open the door to him at once when he comes and knocks. Blessed are those servants whom the master finds awake when he comes. Truly, I say to you, he will dress himself for service and have them recline at a table, and he will come and serve them. If he comes in the second watch or in the third and finds them awake, blessed are those servants." The Gospel of the Lord.
My dear people of God, the word of God says, "Blessed are those servants whom the master finds awake when he comes." The Lord is always there to behold us, to bless us, and to adorn us with peace and happiness. We come to the shrine of Saint Jude to pray. We pray with the written text, verbal prayer. We also say mental prayer. We pray putting our petitions and intercessions. We have intercessory prayers. We put forward our grievances to God. We put our petitions to the Almighty. God always hears the prayers of his people. We have read in the life of the saints that they always grew more and more in prayer life. We complain most often that when I pray, I am distracted. I am distracted because of my worldly concerns. My worldly concerns pull me back. I am not able to give myself totally to God because I am distracted with many things. Jesus, in the house of Lazarus, said to Martha, 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 you are busy with many things. But what is one thing is essential. And Mary has taken the best part. It shall not be taken away from her. Mary was gazing at the face of Jesus. She sat near Jesus, and that was sufficient for her. Jesus is with her. Her life is full. Full with riches. And she feels that she is blessed. This is the feeling that many of the pilgrims feel within themselves, that we are blessed. God is there in our life. There is peace, there is tranquility, there is happiness, there is joy in our life, and we are all taken away from the worries and anxieties of the worldly things, and we are at the feet of God. Some grow in prayer by a meditation, getting lost in the divine blessings that they have received. They thank and praise and glorify God. Their hearts are lifted up to the heaven from the material things. And they are in the meditative mood. The meditation grows more. It grows into contemplation. It's a blessing at that time that you don't know the pain, you don't know worries, you don't know the anxieties of the world. You are lost in God. You are in contemplation. You are one with the author of life, the source of all goodness. And you bless God, praying to God. You have come to the right place. You have come to the shrine of St. Jude. When we feel with the richness of graces of God, and we get lost in prayer. The contemplative prayer grows again to ascetic prayer, and the prayer where affections grow more and more. Your sentiments and affections grow to the Lord. You feel that you are loved within yourself. Many feel that there is nobody to love me, but one who has lifted up his hearts to God feel that God loves him immensely. Though there was anxieties, though there was worries of the world, though there was problems in the world, he is loved by God. She is loved by God. And God loves her and loves the person. And the soul is lifted up in love and in union. The affections grow from oneself to the Lord. The sentiments grow from, and we pour down ourselves in front of the Almighty. This is my life. I surrender my life completely to you. And God blesses you abundantly, takes your affections and pours down his affections and sentiments, and that turns into work. You also show mercy. You also show compassion. You show charity. You become generous because God had been generous to you. God had been merciful to you. God has been gracious to you. And that turns into your work in your daily life,
you turn to be loving to others. You start showing mercy and compassion and affection to others, because what you experienced from God is flowing through you to others. Again, this affective prayer grows more and more into ecstasies. You get the joy and happiness within yourself. The soul enjoys because you are in union with the Father. The Lord is loving you. You experience tremendous joy and happiness. That is turning the prayer into a union with the Almighty God. And there you experience ecstasies. You are forgotten from this world. The worries of the world, you are forgotten. Everything, nobody think, nothing can distract you. And you are elevated to a realm of happiness and joy. The ecstasies come to your life. My dear friends, this is not just stories. These are not dreams. These are the growth of a soul in the union with the Father. And we experience this. In the life of the saints, we experience. And that is what is given to us, to experience the joy and the happiness of prayer. And we have come to this. Though there was disturbance of the virus 19, COVID-19, we are disturbed, we are worried, but we took the challenge. We will come and pray. We will pray to the Lord, and the Lord will remove this virus from us and will give us the happiness and joy. And we forget everything. We are in ecstasies with the Lord, in prayer, one with the Lord, to lifting up our hearts in completely to the union with the Father Almighty. Let us pray. Let us learn to pray. Let us together pray. And one body of Christ, as the church, let us pray. His Holiness Pope Francis is inviting all of us to participate in the Synod as a one body of Christ, in communion with the Lord, in the communion with the church, and the communion with one another. Let us pray. Let us surrender ourselves. Let us give ourselves completely to the Lord. You will see you are blessed. As the word of God says, blessed are those servants whom the master finds awake when he comes. He is coming and we are awake. We are responding to his call in prayer. And in prayer, he will meet us, and the ecstasies and joy and happiness will come to us as a blessing. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us put together our prayers and petitions to the Heavenly Father and participate in the prayer of the faithful, asking God to bless all of us, to glorify God the Almighty, so that we may express our thanksgiving in glorifying and praising God. We say together, Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our Catholic Church, Holy Father Pope Francis, our Bishop Peter Parapalil, and all the priests and religious, that they may be strengthened by the Holy Spirit to guide and lead the people of God. Let us pray to the Lord. Holy Father Pope Francis has inaugurated the Synod on 17th of October 2021 to illumine the heart and mind of all the faithful and fill them with the Holy Spirit to commune, to participate, and to contribute to the mission of the Church. Let us pray to the Lord. Let us pray for our dear devotees of Saint Jude, those who have come from far and wide, They are here with immense love and faith. Lord, grant all their prayers, heartfelt desires and intentions. Keep them always in your grace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the youth, that they may progress with the desire and hope in life, have the courage and enthusiasm to rise to the challenges of our times, and they learn to grow in the love of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, we pray for all who have become sick and in anxiety by the coronavirus that has been spreading throughout the world. In your mercy and compassion, deliver us from this disease. In your wisdom and guide all who are working to eradicate this virus. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us put forward our own intentions, our personal intentions, and pray in silence. Almighty and ever-living God, so many people have asked us to pray for their intentions. So many sick people have asked us to pray. We bring before you all the petitions and intercessions that are in our hearts and minds. You touch our hearts and minds and heal those sick people. Lord, grant abundance of blessings on the devotees come over here, that they may feel that they are blessed by you, and help us to help them to lift up their hearts to you in union with you, so that they may experience the ecstasies of union with the Almighty. We pray this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you.
pray, brethren, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for all the good and glory of his holy church.
Almighty and ever living God, each year we recall the glory of your Saint, your apostle Saint Jude Thaddeus. Accept our gifts and prepare us to celebrate these holy mysteries. We ask this in the name of Jesus our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For you have built your church to stand firm on the apostolic foundations, to be a lasting sign of your holiness on earth, and offer all humanity your heavenly teaching. Therefore, now and for ages unending, with all the hosts of angels, we sing to your glory the unending hymn of praise. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. From on that night he was betrayed, he himself took the bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and broke the bread and gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, St. Jude, Thaddeus, and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Peter, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him, with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by the divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those trespasses against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my room, but only say a word, and my soul shall be healed.
The body and blood of Jesus Christ bring me to everlasting life.
Thank you, dear Bishop, for the solemn inauguration of the Synod 2021-23, and also for offering this Mass for all our devotees, for your prayers and the inspiring words emphasizing on our personal prayer, mental prayer, that will always take us closer to Jesus and to lead a true Christian life. On behalf of all present here, I thank our Lordship for the beautiful words of inspiration, and also for the solemn inauguration of the Synod 2021-2023. I also thank Father Sahainathan, the VG of the Diocese, for briefing what the Synod is. Thank you, dear Father. I also thank all the fathers who have come from different mission stations of the Diocese to solemnize the inaugural day of our novena. Thank you, dear fathers. And also a very big thank to Father Julian and his team from Jodhpur for the beautiful choir. They have really inspired us to pray in a very solemn manner. I also take this opportunity once again to thank Mr. Melvin Rodriguez for providing such beautiful sanctuary for the Shrine of St. George. Thank you, dear Mr. Melvin. On behalf of all present here, I wish you a very happy birthday and a happy, long, long life. I also thank our crew behind the camera, our team behind the camera who helped us to broadcast this event, this solemn, holy event. Thank you, dear friends, for your committed and dedicated work once again. Now may I call upon Father Sahainathan to bring the relic of St. Jude to the altar of the main altar immediately after the final prayer. Thank you.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, in your spirit we pray. May the sacrament we receive today keep us in your loving care as we honor the Saint Jude Thaddaeus, the patron of the desperate and impossible cases. We ask you to bless us abundantly in the Shrine of Saint Jude. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God always keep every adversity far from you, and in His kindness pour out upon you the gifts and blessings.
Amen.
May God keep your hearts attentive to His words, and they may be filled with everlasting gladness.
Amen.
And so you may always understand what is good and right, and be found ever hastening along in the path of God's commands, made co-heirs with the citizens of heaven.
Amen.
May the blessing of the Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit remain with you forever and ever. Go in the peace of Christ. Thanks be to God.
Let us say the Novena prayers together. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. O Lord Jesus Christ, who when on earth did with a long cry and tears offer of prayers and supplication to the Father, receive the offering of this Novena, during which we desire to join our prayers to yours for this intention. We make this offering through Mary, your mother and our mother, and through Saint Jude Thaddaeus, your beloved cousin, for he is the helper in difficult cases. For their sake, accept our prayer and render it fruitful. Amen. O glorious apostle Saint Jude Thaddaeus, patron of desperate cases, who chosen by God to give testimony of true faith, suffered all kinds of tortures, and in the end gave your life rather than deny it. Obtain for us a faith strong as yours, and like you, make us ever ready to confess it with joy, so that we will die rather than deny it. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O faithful apostle Saint Jude Thaddaeus, beloved cousin of our Savior, may the admirable courage with which you sacrificed your life, sooner than fail in your fidelity to true faith and true God, obtain for the grace to be always faithful to God and to the Church in all our duties, so as to merit a share of glory in heaven. Our Father in heaven, holy be your name, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O fervent apostle Saint Jude Thaddaeus, whose only desire was to please God in all things, obtained for the same desire that inflamed the same fervor, we may spend all our life in working out our salvation, so that purified by the fire of tribulation, we may be entitled to the eternal crown of glory in the eternal kingdom of God. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Pray for us, O glorious Saint Jude. Let us pray. O God, who through your blessed apostle Saint Jude has brought us unto the knowledge of your name, again that we may celebrate his eternal glory by making progress in virtue and perpetuating his glory, we may advance in sanctity through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Now our dear Bishop will bless all of us with the relic of Saint Jude, and afterwards no kissing of the relic. Please don't come forward to kiss the relic. It is not allowed. So the blessing today's ceremony comes to an end.